As in the previous class, we have discussed about the scope of political science. As we know, what is the political science means? Political science is nothing but it is a science which deals with the politics. Political science, it enables us to know about the relationship between the state and government. And apart from that, we have discussed about the different definitions which has been given by the different political writers. And we have discussed about the definition of political science is broadly classified into two types. That was traditional classification and modern classification. Definitions were given by the different political writers. And apart from that, we have discussed about the scope of political science. What is the scope of political science? It enables us to know about the relationship between the state and government, how the citizens are participating into the governmental activities in order to get the development into the society. Today we are going to discuss about the significance of a study of a political science. What is significance means? Significance is nothing but it is an importance. That means political science, as we know, is a social science in which it studies about the citizens in relation with the state and government. That means it is showing the relationship of the citizens, how they are participating into the state and government. Without the citizen, does the state will come into the existence? No. Why? Because without the population, state will not be formed. Without the formation of the state, the government will not come into the existence. That means the political science, it enables us to know, to study about the relations, that is the citizens in relation with the state and government. And the significance of political science, it enables us to know about what are the essential into the largest democratic countries like our country India. What is democracy means? Democracy is nothing but for the people, of the people, by the people. That means we, the people of India, we are forming our own government. That means we are forming own our rules and regulation, which is needed for the development of the country. That means the significance of political science, that means it makes us to know about the essentials into the largest democratic countries, and it also analyzes us to know about what it is followed from one country to the another country. In this class, we are going to discuss about the importance of political science. That means, what is the importance of the study of political science in the name of significance? That is nothing but significance of political science. The first significance of political science, it gives the meaning of political theories. What is the political theories? That means how the political theories has came into the existence. As we know, it is the political science, it is a branch of political science where the scientific analysis will be made by the political institutions, and these political institutions, it explains what are the events are there, facts are there, political facts are there, and how they are concerning in order to explain about from one fact to the another fact. The first significance of political science is the political science explains about the concepts and the theory. What type of concepts it explains? It explains about the liberty, equality, fraternity, and how on this basis of these political concepts, how the political systems has came into the existence, and how this political concept, it provides the base for the political system, and what is the political behavior in all its comes under the study of a political science. This is the first significance of political science. What is the first significance of political science? Political science, it explains the concept of political, that is the political concepts and the political theories. That means political science is studies about the relationship between the individual, society and the state. That means what are the responsibilities, what are the rights are given to the individual, how they are performing into the society, and this society, how it is giving the development into the state, it comes under the study of political science. And it also protects, it will provide the liberty, equality, fraternity to the individual. And the study of political science, it also makes to know about, to analyze ourselves, to know about the political theories, concepts and the ethical principles which is necessary for the progressive society. That means if we need the development into the society, what we'll do, we'll study about the history. That means in the history, what it was happened, how we have to overcome with this. This can be studied only by the political science. That means political science, it enables us to study the relationship between the individual, society and the state. This is the first important, this is the first significance of study of political science. What is the first significance of study of political science? Political science explains the concepts and the theory. That is the political concepts and the political theory. That becomes a base for us to visualize what is an ideal state and how the ideal government will come into the existence. What are the ideal institutions are they? For example, like in our country, India, after getting independence, how we have framed our political institutions have been formed, how we have adopted. And so this all, it has been analyzed only through the study of political science. This is the first significance of political science. What is the first significance of political science? Political science explains the concepts of concepts, that is the political concepts and the political theories. The second one, political science examines the forms and the organs, that is the organs of the government. Political science, it enables us to know about types, that is the forms of government. What the forms of government? As we know, there are two forms of governments. Many of forms of governments are there. Democracy is there. And apart from that, political science, it explains every detail about the government and the administration, and it also gives a knowledge about both the rulers and the ruled. That means what are the responsibilities of the rulers, are how they are performing, and how the rulers ruled, they are performing their duties. This comes under the study of political science. And the organs of the government also can be known, can be analyzed and can be known only by the political science. How many organs of the government are there? There are three organs: legislature, executive and the judiciary. Legislature, it plays an important role. That means it is an important organ of the government. Why we are saying it as an important organ of the government? Because the legislature, it makes the laws, whereas the executive, it implements the laws. The most important and the third organ of the government is the judiciary. That means what the judiciary does, it implements. That is an interpretation of the laws can be done only by the judiciary. That means it provides what type of authorities it is carrying, and what are the organs of the government. It can be known only by the study of political science. This is the second significance of political science. What is the second significance of political science? Political science, it examines the forms and the organs of the government. That means the study of political science, it enables us to know about the forms of government and the organs of the government. How we are examining them, how they are performing their duty, we are getting the knowledge about the useful knowledge, which is useful for both for the rulers and the ruled persons also. And how the administrative work differs from the central government to the state government. That means how we are examining only through the study of political science. This is the second importance of study of political science. What is the second significant? Political science, it examines the forms and organs of the government. That means political science, it explains the detail about the government and the administration, how they are divided between the center and the state. What are the organs of the government are they? How they are performing their duties and how they are making the laws which is needed for the development of the society. How the law has been enacted into the government. How this law becomes a popular law. When the law becomes popular, when it is supported by the citizens. If the citizens participate into the political activities, then the ideal state or the ideal country will come into the existence. This comes under the study of political science. The next significance of political science is political science enlightens on the rights and duties. That means here the political science, it explains about the rights and the responsibilities into the detail. That means it studies about the citizens and it makes them to exercise the rights and the responsibilities in the right manner. That means how we are participating into the state. What are the rights are they? If we are ex- exercising our rights. It is the duty of the citizens, whatever the duties has been imposed by the government. This all comes under the study of political science. That means it is a very important political science. It enables us to know about the rights and duties. It shows what type of rights are there. If the rights are explained to us, how we are along with the rights, what are the responsibilities, it will be given in the detail in the study of political science. This is the next important of that is the significance of study of political science. That is, the political science enlightened on the rights and duties of the citizen. That means it enables to educate the citizens about the rights and duties. What are the duties? Duties are nothing but it is a responsibility, that is an obligation which has to be paid by the citizens. It is very compulsory. Without these duties, without the rights, we cannot get the equality, we cannot get the development into the society. That means the citizens, they need the rights and duties. They have to acquire the rights, they have to exercise the rights. Along with the rights, it is the duty of the citizen, that is the obligation should be paid by the citizens also. This is the another significance of study of political science. The next is political science. It explains, the next it is the political science, it provides the knowledge of political thinkers. That means the political thinkers, how they have been utilize the ideas of the political thinkers. This will comes into the existence only by the study of political science. The political science, it enables us to provide the knowledge of the political thinkers and the theories which has been influenced into the world affair. For example, like the philosophers like Rousseau and the Voltaire, they have been laid the foundation, that is the foundation of French Revolution. That means whatever the theories they have been taken the constitution, it has the influence over their work. And the same we can take the writing of the Karl Marx also, which has led to the revolution of Russia, whereas the Mao Zedong, where he has led the revolution of revolutionary trend which has been taken into consideration into the China. And for example, like Mahatma Gandhi, how he has adopted the strategy of Satyagraha and during the time of Indian National Movement, which has given a good impact into the Indian during the time of Indian National Movement. That means the political science, it provides the knowledge of political thinkers also. That means the political thinkers, what they have been taken into the consideration, what the theories were taken, was followed by the political thinkers. And by following these political theories, we can get the influence, what they have been influenced into the world. We can analyze and what we can change the practice, whatever it is practiced by the political thinkers. This is also an extra important, that is the significance of political science. That is the political science, it provides the knowledge of political thinkers also. What is the political thinkers? That means the political science, it enables us to study about the political, that means it provides the knowledge about the political thinkers and the theories which has been adopted by them in order to get the influence into the world affairs. That means how they have been adopted the strategies in order to have the revolutionary changes into the world affairs. That means whatever the theories were practiced, they have been practiced, by using that we can also implement into the state in order to overcome with the problems if it comes existing into the present society. That means if the political science, it enables us to know about the knowledge about the political thinker. This is another significance of a political science. That is, a political science, it provides the knowledge of political thinkers also. The political thinkers, who are the founders are there, who are the political thinkers are there, how they have been adopted this strategy, and what is the realism, is a realism or liberalism or idealism. Liberalism is nothing but a freedom which is given into in the increasing of economy. Idealism, which has been followed by the constructivism, that means by following the human activities, and these human activities, it will be followed forever into the present society also. This is the next important significance of political science. That is, the political science, it provides the knowledge of political thinkers. The next, it is a political science, it deals with international relation. When we are talking about international relation, as in the previous class I have said for you, an isolated state cannot develop. It needs the recognition into the from the one country to the another country. The significance of political science, it gradually increase the relationship between the sovereign independent countries to join into the world political system. That means what it is showing to us, the sovereign for independent countries, sovereign independent countries will have the relationship between the one country to the another country. What is sovereign? Nothing but it is a supreme power. Who is having the supreme power? The state will have the, that is a country will have the supreme power. That means all the powers will be vested in the hands of the state. The nature of the political science, it enables us to know about the international relation, to understand the international relation and the cooperation between the one country to the another country. And it is necessary for us. It becomes a network. After the industrialization, after the modernization and the technological changes has came into the existence, the political science, it enables us to understand about the role of the world, how it can be changing. That means how they have been changing from one country to the another country. For example, like our country India, we are saying it, our country India is a developing nation, whereas America, it is a developed nation. That means if you have a good relation between one country to another country, in that sense, by adopting all the strategies of the developed countries, we can also develop our nation also. This can be understood only by the political science. That means it helps us to understand and evaluate the policy decisions which have been taken into consideration between the one country to the another country. And it also enables us to understand about the international system, which is giving for the better chances where to solve the problems which are known as the important global problems. Whatever the global problems are overcoming, in order to overcome with this global problem also, the political science, it enables us to study about the strategies, and it also evaluate us about the policy decision which has been changing from one country to the another country. This is another significance of political science. That is, the political science, it deals with the international relation. Why we need international relation? It got importance only after the industrialization, modernization and the technological changes has came into the existence, where we need a network connection between the one country to the another country. Without having this network connection, we cannot develop. That means the country isolated cannot be developed. It needs a mutual understanding should be there, which is connected between the one country to the another country. With this analyzation can be done only by the study of political science. That means political science, it deals with international relation. How we are having, how we'll get the international relation when we are becoming a cooperating between the one country to the another country, and we are getting the international recognition also when we are becoming to the part of United Nations organization, that is a UNO. Then only we are getting the international recognition, and we can also know about the political science, what in the detail we can know about what type of strategies will be followed from the one country to the another country. This comes under the significance of political science. That is, the political science, it deals with international relation. It provides us to understand about how the world, that means how they, what is the role of the country into the world, how can it can be changes, how can the changes can be brought into the one country to the another country. It can be understood only by the study of political science. The next and the last is the political science explains about the world organization. What is a world organization? That means United Nations organization, how it has put into the construction. As we know, United Nations organization has came into existence after the First World War, but whereas the mutual understanding and the cooperation was not done, the UNO was failed after the First World War. But again, United Nations organization as an international organization has came into the existence after the Second World War, in order to have to promote the peaceful coexistence and the friendship, that is a friendship among the nation, between the one nation to the another nation. And the United Nations organization, it has the organs are there and their specialized agencies also are there. United Nations organization, there are 6 organs, but at present the trusteeship council has been suspended. For that purpose, United Nations organization, it consists of five organ, that is the Secretary General, Secretary Council is there, General Assembly, Economic and Social Council, International Court of Justice, and International Criminal Court is there, International Court of Justice also is there. That means how many states they have and who will implement them. Whereas a Secretary Council, it is an executive organ. That means the implementation of the laws into the various countries can be done only by the Secretary Council. Whereas the Secretary General, it is a legislative body. That means it will have the implementation, non-permanent members, permanent members are there, it will be changeable. Like this, the organs are there into the United Nations organization. This can be known only by the study of political science. That means the political science, it enables us to know about the United Nations, that is the how the world organization, it explains about the world organization, about the United Nations organization, why it has came into the existence, in order to promote that is promote peaceful and the that is a cooperation and the friendship between the one nation to the another nation. They have been taken into consideration in order to exchange the world understanding, that is undertaking about the various activities for the development of humankind. And the political science, it acquires us with all these matters. It explains about the political science, it explains about the world organization, which has came into existence in order to have the peaceful coexistence between the one nation to the another nation. This study can be done only by the through the political science. Without the political science, we cannot know what the world organization are there, how they are extending their these organs, how they are working, what are the organs of the world, that is the United Nations organization, what are their specialized agencies are there. This can be known only by the study of political science. That means the political science, it enables us to know about how these countries, how this political organization has came into the existence. And at the last, we can say that the knowledge of political science, it is not only indispensable for the present society, but also the scope of political science, it is ever expanding. It changes from the situation, and it will be expanding its authority forever, and with increase the government activities into the welfare state. That means how the government, it is participating in order to have the welfare state. As Aristotle has said that man is a social and a political animal. That means the man without being associated or forming on society, they cannot be developed. At last, we can conclude that the significance of the study of political science, it enables us to know about the present, the society, how we can change by seeing the past. For that purpose also, some political writers, they have been said that the study of state in past, study of state in present, and the study of state in future, what it ought to be, it should come into the conclusion. With this analyzation only, we can know. This can be known only by the study of political science. That means how many salient features of political science are there? That is the significance of political science. That is the first one, the meaning of political theories and the political concepts. Political science examines the forms and organs of the government. The political science enlightens on the rights and duties. Political science provides the knowledge of political thinkers. Political science deals with the international relation. Political science explains about the world organization. These are the significance of political science. The next small topic is there, Muggles. That means how the methods of study of political science can come into the conclusion. That means how we can study the political science. What are the methods are there? That we'll learn today. Methods of study in the political science. When we are learning about the methodology in the political science, it is divided into two types. That is the scientific method, and the second one is the non-scientific method. And this scientific method, again, it is subdivided into, that is the empirical research. Next, it is the statistical or the quantitative method. That means what type of quantity, its methods, it has been provided, and the empirical research, it has been expanded into the observational and the experimental. In the detail, in the further classes, you can discuss, but in the present, you have to know that there are six important methods are there. The first is the historical method, observation method, comparative method, experimental method, philosophical method, and the scientific method. All this has came into existence by the evolutionary process into the political science. How many methods are there in the study of political science? There are six methods into the political science. What are they? They are historical method, observation method, comparative method, experimental method, and philosophical method, and the scientific method. That means this they are the six methods in the study of political science. In the detail you are going to learn into the in your higher classes. That means only you have to know that how many methods of the study, how many methods are there in the study of political science. They are only six. They are historical, observation, comparative, experimental, philosophical, and scientific methods. Thank you, girls. In the next class, upcoming class, we are going to learn about the political science and the other social sciences. And girls, you can write the notes from the description, whatever it is given by the given in the down. And apart from that, the scope of political science, it is very important. It comes for the 10 marks. Where are the significance of political science? It comes for the 5 marks. That means 10 marks already have explained to you. 10 marks answer, you need to write introduction, two definitions, explanation, then last conclusion should be there. But whereas for the 5 marks answer, you are going to write the introduction, that is a explanation of the answer, and the last within the 2 points you write it the conclusion. That's enough for the 5 marks. Very short answers, soon I will give it to you. In the notes, first you write it the scope of political science, first you write the definitions, then next you go definitions of political science, that will be the one answer. And where are the scope of political science, it is for the 10 marks. You write as I have explained the procedure how you have to write for the 10 marks. Thank you.